Hey, howdy guys, Connor McCaskill here with Gear Focus, and today I want to talk to you guys about five hidden features in your Fujifilm that you've probably never heard of. And yes, these should all work with the Fujifilm X-T4, which I am getting soon. So if you guys want to see that content, definitely go head over to my channel and subscribe so you don't miss out on that. Shameless plug out of the way, let's get into the video. The first hidden feature is one that I use all the time, and that is a shortcut to get to the format menu option in the Fujifilm system. So normally, if you want to access the format section of the menus, you have to cycle through a plethora of different options to finally get to what you want, and it's just kind of annoying. So instead, all you have to do is hold down the trash can icon for approximately 2 seconds and then click on the top right back dial once, and presto, you are now in the format card menu where you can quickly erase anything that's on the cards and move on. Super useful. The second secret setting that I want to show you guys is this hidden second level. So normally in the menus, you have the option to turn on a level, which gives you this nifty little guide to make sure that your horizon stays level. However, there is another level to this level, but it has to be assigned as a function button. So let me show you how to do this. Navigate in the menus to the wrench icon, then select the button/dial settings, and then access the function settings. Here is where you set up the second level. Now on my Fujifilm, I have it set up as a swipe function, in particular a swipe down function. Regardless of what you assign it to, just make sure you have one of the function buttons set up to electronic level. Now when I swipe down on the screen, I get a second level that guides my forward and backward tilt, essentially keeping your Fujifilm level in a 3D space, making sure that your shots come out perfect. Number three. Now, admittedly, I don't use this one that often, but I still find it cool. Basically, there is a quick setting change to make your panoramas look just a little bit better. So normally you would take a panorama like so, holding the camera out like this, moving it left to right landscape mode, which is fine. However, I would suggest changing the direction by hitting the right arrow on the back of the camera in the panorama mode. If you don't know how to shoot a panorama on your Fujifilm, it's pretty simple. All you have to do is slide this dial all the way over to the last option. Once you're in the panorama mode and you've pressed the right arrow, instead of selecting from left to right, go down one option and select from bottom to top. Now you're taking the panorama in a portrait style, moving from bottom to top, or still moving left to right, which gives you a fuller and taller image instead of this short, wide, and narrow panorama. I think this way just looks a little bit better. Now, the fourth tip I'm going to show you is how to shoot without a lens. Now, you may be asking, why would I ever want to shoot without a lens? Well, I'm not literally showing you how to shoot without a lens. Rather, I'm going to show you how to shoot with a vintage lens. You see, modern lenses have electronics that communicates with the camera body, basically saying, hey, there's a lens on here. We're all good to record some images. But these old vintage lenses obviously don't have these electronics, so the camera doesn't detect a lens and won't record anything. So in order to override this, go to the menus, find the wrench icon again, select the button/dial settings, scroll down to the second page, and there you will find the option to shoot without a lens. Toggle on, and now your camera will be compatible with vintage glass. Speaking of vintage glass, if you guys want to see the insane history behind this lens, the Helios 44-2 involving World War II, the Red Army, and stolen German designs, definitely go check out my video on the history of this lens. It's super interesting. I think you guys will enjoy it. Still on the topic of vintage lenses, although this feature will work with all lenses, sometimes these old lenses are hard to focus. In fact, I miss focus on the Helios all the time. Now, you can just turn on focus peaking, which I do, but there is another thing that you can do just to give yourself that little extra assurance that your subject is in focus. This one is easy. Just push in on that back dial, the one from the earlier tip on formatting, and now you have a zoomed in image to double check your focus. However, you can go just a bit further by rotating the dial to the right once, and it'll zoom in again. This feature is so useful when shooting with vintage glass, but it can also be helpful when shooting on modern glass when you choose to shoot in the manual focus mode. I hope you guys found these five secret settings useful. I know that they've definitely helped me out when using the Fujifilm system. If you guys want to go see more of my videos, definitely go check out my channel. I make content on all kinds of camera related stuff, but I do tend to focus on Fujifilm because it's my favorite system. Thanks so much to Gear Focus for allowing me to guest host on their channel. They're awesome people. Definitely leave them a like, and as always, thanks for hanging.